And now let's create some highlights with an eraser. So here in the middle, you just place the tip of your eraser in the middle and erase the locks towards the darker hair. So as you can see, I'm going all over in the unpredictable ways, at random, making quick motions. And I use this eraser because the gum is very hard, and I don't know, maybe you can do this with kneaded eraser, but I prefer this one. Because I just cut the top of this gum and I get a sharp edge of the gum again, and I can create tiny highlighted flyaways all over the place like this. And now we can kind of add more shadows next to the roots of the hair using an 8B or any other dark pencil. And but just avoid going over the highlighted hairs that you just created. And make some areas darker with a very dark pencil. And always blend it with a blending stump. Now you don't have now we can start drawing here the lower area. And next to the face, I'm using a B pencil because this section would get less light if our light source is coming from the top right corner. Here we would have heavily shadowed hair. That's why we should use dark pencil here. And shade very carefully here next to the face, because as you can see, we are contouring the face this way. So I don't want to draw the whole area here on the right side, just about an inch wide next to the face. So the rest of the hair, its outer part, it has to be drawn with brighter shade because that will get more light. And don't forget to draw some flyaways all over the face, because this will make the portrait look more natural. Now let's blend it with a tissue. And now let's use an HB lead for the outer area. Just draw straight hair in the direction that you want. Now let's blend it with a tissue. And now we can add some highlighted flyaways with an eraser.